A very warm welcome to one and all. Today, I, Aditya Patil, a final year mechanical engineering student from College of Engineering Pune, will be giving a presentation on the review article titled A Comprehensive Review on Low-Cost Smart Systems Based on an Open Source Platform, Arduino. This paper is co-authored along with me by Mr. Abhishek Patange, Mr. Sujit Pardeshi, Mr. Rugved Vakchaure, Mr. Aditya Medhi, Mr. Rudresh Hegu from College of Engineering Pune, and Dr. R. Jagadishwaran from VIT Chennai. So the flow of today's talk will be, I will begin with the introduction of smart systems and the motivation for this paper. And moving forward, we'll discuss Arduino as an open source hardware as well as an open source software. And then we'll look into some related work in this field of smart system based on the Arduino technology and end today's talk with summarizing the work and findings and seeing the future scope of this technology. In an era of intelligent technology, a system that makes decisions in an adaptive or predictive manner is gaining more attention. Such systems are broadly termed as smart systems, which integrate a variety of sensors, actuators, and control strategies for describing and analyzing a condition in order to execute actions smartly. In general, the term smartness is featured with autonomous activities through networking capabilities, energy efficiency, and closed-loop controls, to name a few. Smart systems combine the segment of machine accuracy and human cognition, putting forward applications ranging from construction, manufacturing, aerospace, to healthcare and ICT, which are both versatile and dynamic. In all the above mentioned domains, there has been an increasing utilization of smart systems, which can be credited to the fact that smart systems reduce challenges pertaining on the global level, like man-made climatic changes, waste, and medical care. The Internet of Things technology, wherein every person and every object is interconnected via the internet, will become more visible due to the ease of the smart system integration. The smart system integration process, which is a combination of various smart systems, is helped by the fact that the sensors available today are increasing in size, increasing in power, and reducing in size, along with other smart components. The process of automating repetitive tasks such as data collection, maintenance, and reporting will help to streamline various multidimensional business processes, in turn helping to assemble the workforce into adding more value. So the motivation behind this article for me was that even though the smart technology is gaining more attention, in order to implement smart systems in real time, an adaptive and economically viable solution is necessary. We all know the smart systems provide greater flexibility. As we have seen before, they can be incorporated into various domains. So it will help organization, apart from the ability to monitor every aspect of device and consumer behavior, it will also help to reduce cost through predictive maintenance and eliminate waste. And these organizations then go on to focus on innovation through robust processes and structural efficiency. In last few years, Arduino as an open source platform has become relatively popular throughout the world. It can be incorporated into a wide variety of smart systems. Also, Arduino has helped to break the stigma that handling of such technology is complex and expensive. So let us look into Arduino as an open source hardware. So Arduino can be described as a circuit board that is open source and programmable and can be incorporated into a large variety of systems, which are both complex and simple. Arduino board consists of a microcontroller, which can be programmed in order to control and sense objects in real time. Arduino communicates with various outputs, such as motor displays and LEDs, by responding to inputs and sensors. The low cost and flexible nature of the Arduino board has helped it to become a sought after choice for people looking to build various smart systems. Massimo Banzi from Italy is credited for introducing the Arduino board to the world back in the year 2005. His primary aim was to provide people from non-engineering background a simple and low-cost hardware tool to use in a variety of projects. Arduino board consists of ready-made software known as Arduino IDE. Arduino boards can read the digital or analog input signals from a variety of sensors and are able to convert these signals into an output, which can be used to carry out various analytical actions. Arduino delivers a standard that helps to divide the functionality of the microcontroller in a more accessible manner. An added advantage of the Arduino board is that no extra piece of hardware is required to transfer a new code into the board. A simple USB cable is sufficient for the job. So let us look into different types of Arduino boards. Arduino comes in a variety of boards depending on different type of microcontroller used. Differences in this board are on the basis of number of outputs and inputs. These boards also differ on the basis of various operating factors such as form factor, speed, operating voltages, etc. So the most commonly used Arduino boards throughout the world are Arduino Uno, Arduino Mega, Arduino Nano, Arduino Mini, Arduino Lilypad, and Arduino Leonardo. So this table here basically summarizes the differences between this board on the basis of the memory, processor, analog input-output pins, digital input-output pins, and the operating voltages. So according to the requirement or the need of the project, the suitable Arduino board can be selected with all these parameters. This is the representation of all the Arduino boards discussed just now. Below shown is the schematic representation of the pin diagram of the Arduino Uno board, which is one of the most popular boards throughout the world. Now, let us look into Arduino as an open source software. The Arduino board consists of a ready-made software known as the Arduino IDE, where IDE stands for Integrated Development Environment, which is mainly utilized for compiling, editing, and uploading a program onto the Arduino board. It is an open source software with purpose of writing and compiling a code. This software is aimed at helping people to easily program any sort of code without having a prior advanced knowledge in the field of programming. A major advantage of this software is that it runs on the Java platform, which comes with inbuilt commands and functions that play a pivotal role for compiling, debugging, or editing any code. The boards are equipped with a microcontroller that is programmed in accordance with the IDE software. Sketch, also known as the main code, which is generated on the IDE platform, ultimately creates a hex file, which is later transferred and uploaded in the controller present on the Arduino boards. Compiler and editor are the two basic features of the IDE platform, where the former is used to upload and compile the code, while the latter is used to generate and edit the code. Arduino IDE software implements the two most old and basic languages, that is C and C++. It is easily accessible and can be downloaded easily from the official Arduino website. Now let us look into some related work in this field of smart system based on the Arduino technology. The first of the author M. Fuentes and his co-authors proposed a new data collection system for monitoring PV systems. The parameter in this experimentation, which are monitored, are voltage, current, power, and temperature using temperature sensor, current sensor, and voltage sensor interfaced with the Arduino board, and a C program is made to collect data through the sensors. The experimentation using the SET system is conducted over a period of 4 months and the data is collected. So the 4 month period of experimentation results in indication of how the new data logger system of Arduino recorded and monitored the data precisely for the complete duration of testing and experimentation. So this figure on the left side, we can see the data acquisition system suggested by the authors for the monitoring of PV systems. Next up, author Jorge Coria and his team of co-authors presented a paper for implementation of new open architecture controller for CNC systems based on open source hardware. The system is based on measuring the inter extrapolated and feedback trajectories using the Arduino Mega microcontroller along with an Arduino Nano microcontroller. So the figure besides shows the data acquisition system. There is the Arduino Nano microcontroller along with the Arduino Mega microcontroller and the CNC systems it is interfaced to. Next up, author Majid Karimi and his team of co-authors suggested a system which helps to monitor the indoor environmental quality and assesses the performance. The major parameters in consideration here are temperature, CO2, and VOC, which were measured using the humidity and temperature sensor interfaced with the Arduino Uno microcontroller and an XB device. So the microcontroller and the XB device were connected using the software named Zigbee. And another software named Voltron was used for the analysis of the collected data. Next up, author Vasily Desnitsky and Igor Kotenko proposed a system for monitoring structural state of elements of hydraulic structures, like a hydraulic dam. The major parameters they considered for this system were pressure, temperature, vibration, and bending, using the low-cost pressure sensors, vibration sensors, and temperature sensors. So they used an Arduino Mega microcontroller and using the software like SIEM technology. And the wiring language was used to collect data from this sensor. Experiments carried out on the hydraulic structure, that is dam. This experiment, which were carried out on modeling occurrence, which violates the exactness of the state of the dam. And they have helped them to establish that the suggested monitoring mechanism is operable in practice. Next up, author Talha Agakayazi and his team of co-authors suggested a method for building a sensor characterization platform for multi-axis stress in order to decrease the time required for the development and incorporate precise benchmarking. The parameters they considered were force and torque. And they collected this data using the force and torque sensor interfaced with an Arduino Uno microcontroller. And they used the LabVIEW software to collect the data. From the experimentation, the stresses obtained were characterized into normal and shear stress. And the graph were plotted for these stresses. And they showed that the capacitance decreases with the shear stress and increases with the normal stress. So below in the figure, we can look into their data acquisition system, where the Arduino Uno board, upon which the connectors and safety switches mounted. And this system is made compact, so it can be used anywhere and quite easy. Next up, author Adam M. Pringle and his team of co-authors presented a multi-sensor monitoring system for quantifying the processes during the wire arc additive manufacturing process. And the major parameters they considered were current and temperature, along with voltage. So besides the, we can see the data acquisition system suggested by them, where the Arduino board, Arduino Nano microcontroller, along with various sensors is put onto this board and made into a compact system. Moving forward, author Deepam Goyal and B.S. Pabla proposed a non-contact SHM system for machine tools based on vibration signals through an inexpensive microcontroller-based DAQ system. So they used an LDR system to collect the signals of main parameter, which is vibration. This sensor, which was interfaced with the Arduino microcontroller, and the collected signals were analyzed using the LabVIEW software. The result obtained from the economical non-contact vibration instrument when compared with the results obtained from the accelerometer displayed that the variation pattern for the both devices was same, hence proving that this data acquisition system is useful and operable in practice. Moving forward, author Anas Islam proposed a system for monitoring and storing welding data parameters using sensors and Arduino microcontroller. So below figure shows the schematic representation of using the Arduino Mega microcontroller along with various sensors like the piezo ceramic sensor, vibration sensor, and the ADXL335 accelerometer used for collecting various parameter data such as current, temperature, vibration. Finally, Iani Cruz and his team of co-authors presented an inexpensive system for online process controlling and monitoring for ensuring stable and efficient biogas production. So the main parameters they considered here were the pH value, temperature, and the biogas yield. And a biosensor, along with pH sensor and temperature sensor, were interfaced with the Arduino microcontroller. The control processes and monitoring maintained the required temperature, conditions, and pH, displaying satisfactory results. So, the summarizing the work which we have just discussed, in this table, we can see the table is divided into several columns where the application of the articles were discussed, along with the parameters to be monitored, the sensor used to collect this parameter data, along with the controller with which they are interfaced, and software used to analyze this data. Moving on to the findings and the future scope of this technology. The Arduino technology helps in breaking the notion that microcontrollers are difficult to operate. Arduino boards are open source entity, both in hardware and software front, which makes it easier even for the people from non-engineering background to utilize it in various interactive projects. In today's world, the need for an inexpensive system is rising, and the Arduino technology quite efficiently caters to this need by providing cheaper options to utilize. And not only that, but it also presents variety in terms of different types of board, as accentuated in this paper. This paper advocates that the Arduino technology has potential to be used in various fields as a primary choice for implementation of smart system projects relating to this field due to its ease of access and handling. In recent years, the Arduino technology has boomed onto the scene as a major cheap and simple option for utilization of microcontrollers in different types of projects. Although until now, the application of this technology is frivolous, but the current advances highlight the potential it holds, especially in the field of technology like Internet of Things. So here are the references we have used for this article. So I hope this presentation was helpful for understanding the current advances made in the smart system processes and the Arduino technology, and how the Arduino technology has boomed onto the scene and how it has gained more and more support from all around the world, and it has become a sought after piece of technology. Even though the current advances highlight that the Arduino technology is currently coming onto scene, there are some disadvantages of Arduino, and which are overcome by various other technologies like the Raspberry Pi. And in future, we hope that the Arduino technology will only improve from here on, and again, the smart systems will be available quite economically, and they will be feasible for the public throughout the world. Thank you for listening, and have a good day.